What's going on, guys? It is Bernardo, and today is all about installing Enterprise Root Certificate Authority using Windows Server 2022. So let's get right into it. All right, so this is a big one because we are actually installing, configuring, and creating a GPO for our CA server, right? So the first thing that I'm going to do is I'm actually going to show you that my virtual machine that I'm building everything out is using Windows Server 2022. It's actually version 21H2, right? Build 2348. First thing that I did was I clicked on Start. I opened up the Server Manager. Within Server Manager, on the upper right-hand side, I clicked on Manage. I clicked on Add Roles and Features. You're going to get the Feature Wizard. Click Next here. Click Next here. Click Next here. And we need to locate our Active Directory service certificate, and we're going to check that off. You're going to get add features that are required for the Active Directory certificate services. Just click on add feature. Excellent. Click next there. Click next here. Click next here. And for the roles and services, make sure that certification authority is enabled. Click next. Click install. It's going to start installing, and eventually it's going to give you this. Once it gives you this, we're going to click on the link that says configure Active Directory certificate services on the destination server. So click on it. It's going to prompt you this. So if you want to change the credentials, go for it. I left everything as is. I clicked on next here. The only role that I selected to configure will be certification authority. Click next here. I actually left it as an enterprise CA, so click next. For the type of CA, I want to do a root CA, so click next here. For the private key, I want to create a new one, so click next. I left everything as the default. It's pretty standard for me within my environment, but you are able to change it. Click next here. For the CA name, it actually pre-populates everything for you, but if you want to change it, go for it. I click next. For the configuration period for your CA, by default is 5 years. I bumped it up to 10 years. I click next here. This is the default location for your certificate database, so click next. A confirmation of everything that you just did, just click on configure. If everything goes well, you should get a green check mark with configuration succeeded. Click close. Click close here, close this out. We're going to click on the start menu. We're going to open up your Windows administrative tools, and we're going to locate your certification authority. Boom, it launches up. So we're just going to open it up. We're going to select certificate templates. We're going to right click on it and click on manage. And within manage, we're going to locate and select the workstation authentication template. So I'm going to right click on it and I'm going to duplicate the template. And once I duplicate the template, the first thing I'm going to do is go to general. I'm going to change the template display name as well as the template name. Awesome. Next thing that we need to do is go inside the subject name. And for my environment, I'm going to enable the user principal name or the UPN. Then I'm going to go to security. And within security, we're going to click on domain computers. And by default, it already has enroll, but I want to make sure it has read and also auto enrolled. And once you do all that, we're going to click apply and okay it. We're going to close this up. It's going to take us back here, and we're going to right click on the certificate templates, and we're going to click on new, and we're going to click on certificate template to issue. And there goes our new template that we just created. So select it, click OK, and then it gets imported inside the certificate template node. Almost done. So we're going to open up our group policy management, and I'm going to go inside my group policy objects, and I'm going to right click on it, and I'm going to go new, and I'm going to give my GPO the following name, right? Certificate enrollment policy, pretty standard. And it's going to hit the computer node, and we are going to click OK. We're going to locate our new GPO. I'm going to right click on it, click on edit. And within edit, we are going to go inside the following. We're going to go inside computer configuration. We're going to open up policies. We're going to go inside Windows settings. We're going to go inside security settings. We're going to go inside the public key policies. And within there, inside the root of public key policies, we're going to locate certificate services client auto enrollment. So we're going to double click on that. We're going to click on the drop down menu and then select enabled. Once you click enable, it gives you the following settings. And I'm going to check off the first two, renew expired certificates, as well as update certificates that use certificate templates. And then we're going to apply it, okay it, good. We're going to locate automatic certificate request settings. So we're going to select that. right-click on it, click on New, click on Automatic Certificate Request. It's going to give you this nice little wizard. So click Next here. We're going to click Next again, and we're going to click on Finish. We're going to close our GPO, and our GPO, we're going to apply it to our Windows OU. Now, I applied it to my Windows OU because this is where I have all my workstations. And basically, you're able to do a GP update force for your machines to get it. Now, within that OU, I have a V Windows 11 computer object. This is my computer that I have on that OU, which is great because hopefully it will get auto-enrolled. We're going to go back inside our CA server. And if you go inside a CA server, eventually, give it some time. If you go inside issued certificates, you should see this, right? Requester name, which would be the computer name. Awesome. And it was applied a certificate. Now, if you want to double check and make sure everything is working correctly, this is one way. But another way is let's go inside the Windows server or whatever workstation. If you go inside the local computer certificate and you go to personal and then go to certificates, you're going to see those two certificates that your CA server is providing to your workstation using the group policy. How awesome is that? And that's it, guys. Hopefully, you guys enjoyed this video, and I catch you guys on the next one. Peace out.